Final game last episode becomes first game this episode. We're returning to Yu-Gi-Oh! The Dawn of Destiny. Continuing on my sort of Professor Oak's challenge where I get the largest amount of cards available before unlocking a new character, except for those maybe possible, maybe not, zero weight cards. I'm starting off by unlocking the final duelist of tier 2, Joy Wheeler, who after getting the new cards from the last two, has 24 cards left for me to win. When I win in triple duel to unlock him, I choose the Obelisk statue and win Guilty of a Dark Knight. Moving to single duel and sticking with the Obelisk statue, I win Koji Kosi, Tiger Axe, Rock Ogre Grotto No. 1, Battle Steer, Armored Lizard, Zombire of the Dark, Axe Raider and Garuzis. I then move on to the Ra statue to win a Wolf, and then on to Slifer for Panther Warrior, Swordsman of Landstar, Alligator's Sword, Thousand Dragon and Flame Swordsman. Now for the triple duel rewards. Starting with the Obelisk statue, I win Swamp Battleground and the Warrior Returning Alive. Then from the Ra statue I win Burning Spear, Hungry Burger and Hoshi Ningen before moving on to the Slifer statue. From that I win Lightning Blade, Carbolan the Warrior, Salamandra and finally Musician King, which gets me to 393 cards and 38%. Joey is a complete pushover right now. He doesn't have any 2k defenders like Teya or Tristan. He does have Zombire of the Dark and Panther Warrior but barely uses them. He doesn't have his Red Eyes Black Dragon yet either, so his strongest monster ends up being Thousand Dragon. But even that doesn't help him since like Yugi, he keeps summoning his Time Wizards and losing them to its effect before he can fuse them. The only other card I remember being a threat from him is Change of Heart, but we've not seen the last of Joy yet, so we'll see how that goes. Joy was actually my favourite character watching Yu-Gi-Oh! As a kid. I was more invested in his goings on than the other main characters. The Pharaoh's memories were such a vague, undefined thing for so long that I wasn't too interested, and Kaiba was a prick who I wanted to see lose at every step in his life. Joy was the one who felt like he had actual definable stakes. In Duelist Kingdom there's pain for his sister's surgery, and then Battle City had everything with Mai and the writer's utter failure at writing Just Friends. I was more invested in his grudge against Marek than Marek's against the Pharaoh. I remember being pretty salty that they actually wrote Joey essentially winning the duel against Marek but having him lose on a technicality because he ends up in a coma before he can declare the game winning move that was 100% going to happen. Just have him lose properly, you dicks. Yeah, he played a garbage deck, pretty much relying on Time Wizards and Baby Dragon through the first story arc. But the thing is, I don't play the card game anymore, and when I did almost two decades ago, I was neither good nor a serious player. But every main character played utter garbage from what I remember. I don't need to be an experienced player to know why having three Blue Eyes and Obelisk of Tormentor in the same deck is a bad idea. Moving on to tier 3, I have to face Bakura, Shadi and Yami-Yugi with 8,000 life points. Bakura and Shadi both have 3,000 while Yami-Yugi has 4,000. As for new cards, Bakura has 30, Shadi has 28 and Yami-Yugi has 18, so Bakura is first. Shadi took about 3 turns to bring down, Yami-Yugi 2, and 3 again for Bakura. I chose the Obelisk statue, winning the Little Swordsman of Islay. Onto single duel, I stick with the Obelisk statue and win Gorgon Egg, Ancient Brain, the Gross Ghost of Fled Dreams, Megaris Light, Claw Reacher, the Shadow Who Controls the Dark, Baron of the Fiend Sword, the Dudek, Job Change Mirror, the Portrait Secret, Man-Eating Treasure Chest, Dark King of the Abyss, Terror of the Terrible, Trial of Nightmare, Mystic Clown, That Which Feeds on Life, and Dark Prisoner. I then move on to the Ra statue for Lord of Zemia and Whiptail Crow. This one was between recordings and I forgot to start the next one when I got it. I then get Headless Knight and then move to the Slifer statue for Gravekeeper's Servant and Mahavilo. Now all that's left is the triple duel rewards. I skip the Obelisk statue and move right onto Ra for Silver Bow and Arrow and Hero Shadow Scout. Next is a Slifer statue for Penguin Knight, Skellingel, Non-Aggression Area, Shining Angel and Vile Germs. This gets me to 424 cards and 41%. Bakura is another one who was a pushover. He has some stronger spells to drag things out, but his deck is mainly an equip deck focused on Mahavilo, and I don't think he managed to equip a single spell on Mahavilo across every game I played against him. In the series itself, I don't remember too much of him, since his alter ego gets most of the screen time. I just remember him being in various comas. Next is Shadi, who after getting the cards from Bakura, now has 27 cards to win. I beat him last in triple duel, but don't win any new cards. In single duel, starting with the Obelisk statue, I win Petite Angel, Tenderness, Millennium Golem, Doma the Angel of Silence, Binding Chain, Needleworm, Orion the Battle King, and Attack and Receive. From the Ra statue, I win Occubeam, Winged Egg of New Life, Ray and Temperature, Wing Egg Elf, Shining Friendship, Dark Witch, and Card Destruction. I then move on to the Slifer statue, getting Morphing Jar No. 2, and 2 hours later, Chain Energy. This leaves a triple duel rewards. From the Obelisk statue, I win Amoeba and Nobleman of Crossout. The latter replaces one of the Mystic Tomatoes in my deck. I then move on to the Ra statue. I get Weather Report on my first try, but then it takes me 3.5 hours for Stainstorm and Pyramid Energy. I would have moved on to Slifer, but I noticed I missed a card that can only be won on the Obelisk statue, so I go back to that one. Another hour and a half later, I finally get Eternal Rest. This statue does have one more card, but it can also be won through the Slifer statue, so I move on to that. On my first Lifa statue, I get Seal of the Ancients and Fairy King Truesdale, just leaving Dark Piercing Light, which took another 45 minutes, and Driving Snow, which took half an hour after that. This has me at 451 cards and 44%. Shardy is the biggest pain in the arse to duel so far. It plays a burn deck, combining Magic Fawn with the likes of Gravekeeper's Servant, Cyberjar, and Morphin Jar number 2. If you don't draw Royal Decree first turn, you're in for a tedious time because he will load up on 17 negate attacks, magic jammers and enchanted javelins first turn. He's not hard to beat, it just takes fucking forever, and when you're about to get in the last battle phase to win and his set monster turns out to be Morphin Jar number 2, you're just like, fuck's sake. It didn't help that after Joey and Bakura being relatively quick to win all the cards I need, Shardy also took 3 times as long as either of them since most cards I needed to win from him were 10 weight or lower. I know people prefer their Yu-Gi-Oh games to not be over in a couple turns, but when you have to grind matches in a video game, it gets old quick. Shardy is another one I don't remember too much of in the series itself. I know he was kind of mysterious and would show up to give vague advice or glimpses into the past, but that's all I remember. I also remember his face looking pretty different. He never had eyes like that with that vacant stare. Looking it up, he was murdered 5 years before the start of the series, and after the experience of grinding his cards, good. Finally, for tier 3 is Yami Yugi, who now has just 17 cards to win. I pick Obelisk when I unlock him and get Defusion. I already have all his Obelisk rewards from single duel, so I move on to the Ra statue where I have only 2 cards to win. The downside is that both of them are cards with a weight of 5. The upside is that it only took... I forgot to put in the number. Right, I've looked it up again, it were 2. The upside is that it only took 2 games to win Change of Heart, which replaced the other Mystic Tomato, and then one more to win Dark Hole, which replaced Maneater Bug. Slifer next, and the 3 cards I need from that statue all have a weight of 8 or 5. Not to mention the Slifer statue has double the pool of rewards that the Ra statue has. 2 wins in gets me a second Gemini Elf to replace one of my Neos. Half an hour later I get Summoned Skull, and another half an hour later I get Call of the Haunted and a third Gemini Elf to replace the other Neo. An hour and a half later I get Dark Magic Ritual, and then it takes another hour to win Magician of Black Chaos to go with it. Now I can move on to the triple dual rewards. Due to the muscle memory of constantly picking Slifer, I go with it again instead of Obelisk and win Skull Guardian. Next time I actually choose Obelisk and get the incredible luck of winning all cards I needed from it at once. Horn of Light, Resurrection of Chakra, and Monster Recovery. After the slog I was having in single duel, I needed that. I already have all the Ra rewards, so it's back to Slifer for the Eye of Truth. Then Banner of Courage, Beast of Gilfa, and Spellbinding Circle all at once. And then it's another hour and a half until I win the last 3 at once. The Anketo the Cure Master, Buster Blader, and Big Shield Gardener. This puts me at 469 cards and 46%. Yami Yugi's a little like dueling Shardy, but much less painful. He also has the negate attacks and cyber jars and morphin jar number 2s, but so's the rest of the annoying traps with the same 2k defenders as regular Yugi. His main downfall is that he's too reliant on tribute monsters. He has 3 summoned skulls along with the Curse of Dragon, plus Gaia, plus Dark Magician, and he has Magicians of Black Chaos too. Most of these are easy to deal with using traps, and all of my beaters with a single equip spell get over his defenders, leaving him with no tribute fodder most of the time. The one single time he ever beat me was by Raigekiing my board while I had a single card in hand, and me being unlucky enough to not draw any monsters for several turns. And even in that game he still showed our genius AI tributing off his summoned skulls for another summoned skull. I think most of us preferred Yami to Yugi simply because he's the one who gets to do everything. I get that the main plot is recovering his memories, but Yugi is supposed to be the main character, so it would be nice for him to do more. I don't know what it's like in the manga though. Speaking of, I hear the manga starts off with Yami as a more dark and vicious character, but those of us in the UK in 2003-2004 watching on Nickelodeon or Sky One didn't get to see that, since we didn't have the manga or Season Zero. The only time they're like, what if the Pharaoh is evil, is when he calls Kaiba's bluff on killing himself, and I can't call causing the death of a dick-headed kidnapping attempt to murder a billionaire evil. On to tier 4, where I have 10,000 life points to duel Weevil Underwood, Rex Raptor and Mako Tsunami, all with 4,000 LP each. Rex has the most cards to win at 84, followed by Mako with 80 and Weevil at 76, so Rex is the next one I'll unlock. Weevil took quite a few turns to beat thanks to Swords of Revealing Light and his Maneater Bug slowing me down. Mako then only took 2 turns and just 2 battle phases to Rex. I choose the Obelisk statue and win Fiend Reflection number 2, Crazy Fish and Mechanical Chaser. I also realised that I never swapped out my large ints for Mechanical Chasers despite that 50 attack point increase. Sticking with Obelisk in single duel gets me Two-Headed King Rex, Meteor Dragon, Wicked Dragon with the Ersatz Head, Drooling Lizard, Crocodilus, Grappler, Jormungandr, One-Eyed Shield Dragon, Ancient Lizard Warrior, Beaked Snake, Crawling Dragon and Two-Mouthed Dark Ruler. There is one more card I can win from this, but I can also win it in the Ra statue. Said statue wins me Crawling Dragon number 2, Anthrosaurus, Urabi, Bee Dragon Jungle King, Fairy Dragon, Taiho No. 2, Lesser Dragon, Yamadron, Little D, Megazola, Mad Sword Beast, Sky Dragon, Sword Arm of Dragon, and Brachioridos. Every reward from the Slifer statue I've already won, so now it's Triple Duel. This will take a while thanks to having an entirely new pool of Triple Duel rewards, rather than the one the first three tiers shared with a couple character specifics on top. Starting with Obelisk, Iwing Tongyo, Stone D, Gilosaurus, Violent Rain, Armor Knight, Yaranzo, Wow Warrior, Kamakiri Man, Armored Starfish, Sea Carmen, Pragtigal, Night Lizard, Guardian of the Sea, Blocker, Gigatech Wolf, Hyosbe, Temple of Skulls, Cyber Soldier of Dark World, Kuwagata Alpha, Behegon, The Snake Hare, Robotic Knight, Takuhi, High Tide Gyojin, Brave Scissor, and Golgoyle. There are still three more cards I can win from the Obelisk statue, but they can also be found in the others, so I move on to the Ra statue. From this one, I win Darkfire Dragon, Seven Coloured Fish, Aqua Dragon, Flying Penguin, Kaiser Dragon, Magical Ghost, Raised Body Heat, Turtle Tiger, Faith Bird, and Fiend Reflection No. 1. And then I forgot to hit record yet again, missing me picking up Thunder Dragon, Spirit of the Books, Skull Red Bird, and Blue Wing Crown. After realising I fucked up on hitting record, I get Gokibore, Fire Dragon, Disc Magician, Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon, Dragon Treasure, Takriminos, Winged Dragon Guardian of the Fortress No. 2, and Giant Red Sea Snake. I then get another reason why this game isn't a good fit for a Professor Oak's challenge. When I lose the duel against Weevil thanks to millions of lucky traps keeping me from doing anything, the consolation prize is from his pool, so I win a single Lava Moth. And if you can win cards from characters you haven't unlocked yet by losing to them, the entire idea behind applying the challenge to this game just falls apart. And I thought I was on with a good idea when I first started this. After a few more wins, I get Taihon and Dragon's Gunfire, letting me move to the Slifer statue. From it, I get Guardian of the Throne Room, D-Tribe, a Wingbeat of Giant Dragon, Soul Eater, Flying Kamakiri No. 2, and finally, Ground Attacker Bugroth. This brings me up to 54% at 554 cards. Would have been 553 if not for that loss to Weevil. Rex is by far the easiest character to duel in the game. His only threat is a Raigeki he has. The main reason is simple, he has no traps in his deck so I can simply beat over his monsters to win every time. In the series itself, he has that one loss against Joey and then they team him with Weevil for filler shenanigans, but I'll say the rest of that when I talk about Weevil. Next is Mako, who after clearing out Rex's triple duel rewards has 32 cards left to win. First, when unlocking him in triple duel and choosing Obelisk, I win Deep Sea Shark, Steel Shell, and Umi Ruka. Sticking with Obelisk in single duel gets me Flying Fish, Umi, Misairu Zame, Sea King Dragon, Jellyfish, Boulder Tortoise, Amphibian Beast, Fiend Kraken, and the Legendary Fisherman. Moving to the Ra statue, I win Kairyu Shin, Bottom Dweller, Root Water, Octobursa, Akihiron, 30,000 Year White Turtle, Spike Seedra, Giant Turtle Who Feeds on Flames, Rainbow Marine Mermaid, Turtle Bird, and a Legendary Ocean. I then move on to the Slifer statue that only has one card for me to get. 20 minutes later, I get Tornado Wall, sending me back to Triple Duel and the Obelisk statue for Rare Fish, Fortress Whale, and Fortress Whale's Oath. Everything else can be won from the Slifer statue, and there's a smaller reward pool with Slifer so it should be quicker. Or so you would think. I win Marine Beast, Return of the Doomed, Beast King of the Swamps, and Man-Eating Black Shark. They were fine, but it was the last card, Roaring Sea Snake, that was a problem. In the end, it took 5.5 hours when I got it just randomly trying the Obelisk statue instead. I don't know why that one was such a problem. This brings me to 586 cards and 57%. Mako is harder than Rex since he actually uses traps. He has a set of Torrential Tribute he draws nearly every first turn. His main threat is combining Umi or a Legendary Ocean with Tornado Wall so I can't damage his life points, but a Royal Decree, MST or Feather Duster deals with that. When it comes to traps, he's nowhere near as bad as the next guy. Don't remember him all that much in the series itself. I know he had one of the more bullshit duels in Duelist Kingdom with his "my water monsters can't be hit cause they're hiding," and then Yugi having his giant soldier destroy his moonspell to beach them. Then in Battle City, something about "my daddy's a trading card" or something like that, I don't remember. That just leaves Weevil, who won't have 27 cards left to win, but thanks to that loss and the card I won from it, has 26. When unlocking him, I picked the Obelisk statue for Quagga Hercules, Insect Soldiers of the Sky, and Forest. Sticking with Obelisk in single duel gets me Spiked Snail, Acid Crawler, Kumo Toko, Basic Insect, Dungeon Worm, Hunter Spider, Alien Section, and Giant Scorpion of the Tundra. I then move on to Ra, which gets me Giant Flea and Nightmare Scorpion. Then it's over to the Slifer statue where it takes another hour to win Widespread Ruin. Back to triple duels on the Obelisk statue and I win Laser Cannon Armor and Insect Imitation. An hour later I get Great Moth, then Cocoon of Evolution, and finally, Perfectly Ultimate Great Moth and Infinite Dismissal. The rest can all be won from just the Ra statue. I get Blade Fly, Insect Barrier, Flying Kamakiri number 1, and Drill Bug. But like Mako, Weevil's last card, Parasite, would just not show up with its wave 5. It took another 4.5 hours just to get it, and after 131 triple duels between them, I'm glad to leave this tier behind. This brings my card total to 611 out of 1017, or 60%. Weevil is just like Shaddy, but worse. It feels like 80% of the time he opens with 4 traps, always some combination of Torrential Tribute, Trap Hole, Negate Attack, and Widespread Ruin. Of course, I don't get that same luck with my MST's Royal Decree off Everduster, so most of the time his opening hand just shuts me off from playing the game for multiple turns. And he also has Raigeki and 3 Maneater Bugs just to make things take longer. Like, I'm not complaining about the fact he has a good deck, but the fact I have to repeat the duel against him to win certain cards with such low drop rates. Like with Shaddy, if most of the opponent's deck functions to drag the game out, it just makes the grind so much more unbearable. I really hated Weevil watching the show, a character who should have been a one-off but they wouldn't stop bringing back. It feels like a very common thing in Japanese media, the character that's always around and very annoying and that's the entire joke. The one that comes to mind for me is Mr. Satan in Dragon Ball, but Rex and Weevil come nowhere near the likability of that guy. I never really got it. Do people actually like these no-depth characters who exist to fill the role of annoying person? I'd rather have just watched the characters I was invested in. Like, they come back in more serious roles in Waking the Dragon, but by that point I don't care. Fuck off. And that brings me to tier 5, where I have 11,000 life points to duel Bones with 4,000, Bandit Keith with 5,000, and Pegasus at 6,000. Bones has 30 new cards, Pegasus has 28, but it's Bandit Keith I'm starting with at 38 new cards. Pegasus takes 4 turns to bring down, Bones only takes 2, and Keith himself takes 3. I pick the Obelisk Statue and win Germ Infection, Machine Conversion Factory, and Amphibious Bugroth. Sticking with Obelisk in single duel gets me Gradius, Megasonic Eye, Zoa, Cybertech Alligator, Cyber Soldier, Saber Slasher, Slot Machine, which is one of his rarest drops for some reason, Giant Mech Soldier, Pendulum Machine, Cannon Soldier, Ancient Tool, Shovel Crusher, Giganto, Mechanical Snail, Steel Ogre Grotto number 1, Machine Attacker, Barrel Dragon, and Metal Fish. I start choosing the Ra Statue for Limiter Removal, Gatekeeper, Mech Bass, Holograph, and Dice Armadillo. I then alternate between Obelisk and Slifer until I win Launcher Spider, then it's Triple Duel. From Obelisk I get Buster Rancher, Patrol Robo, Cyclone Laser, and Cybersaurus. Then onto the Ra Statue, where it takes half an hour to win Metal Dragon, another half an hour to win Jinzo number 7, and 2 more Triple Duel runs to stop defence. All I had left to do was keep choosing the Slifer Statue for another hour and a half to win Machine King, and now I have 649 cards and I'm at 63%. After having to deal with Weevil, Keith was a nice reset, it was no problem at all. The one loss I had was because he had 3 trap holes on the field at once and I stupidly filled out my back row and couldn't use the spells in my hand that would have saved me. Not as easy as Rex, but close. The fact he'd constantly power up his machines with equips only to tribute them off the same turn for monsters weaker than the original powered up monster helped too. Keith is a good example of how they didn't need to constantly drag the same side characters kicking and screaming back into the show. It was a memorable dickhead in Duelist Kingdom and got one more appearance just before Battle Sea to set up the next villain and that was it. He was done and we never saw him again. And it was fine, Weevil. But enough complaining, it's onto the last character for this episode, Bones, and the 30 cards I need to win from him. First, when unlocking him in Triple Duel, I choose Ra to win Skull Lair. Then back to Obelisk in Single Duel, I win Clown Zombie, Wood Remains, King of Yami Makai, Blue-Eyed Silver Zombie, Neck Hunter, Ghoul with an Appetite, Mabarrel, Dokuroi's Over Grim Reaper, Graveyard and the Hand of Invitation, The Earl of Demise, The 13th Grave, Metal Guardian, Call of the Grave, Corroding Shark, Ushi Oni, and Call of the Dark. The cards I don't have in the Ra Statue can also be won from the Slifer Statue, so I move straight to that. All there is to win from this one is Morinthen, Dark Chimera, and Air Eater. For Triple Duel, every remaining card can be won from the Ra Statue. I win Crass Clown, Call of the Mummy, Offerings to the Doomed, Great Mammoth of Goldfine, Barox, The Shallow Grave, Violet Crystal, Flame Ghost, Skelgon, and then after an hour of nothing, Skull Knight. This brings me up to 679 cards and 66%, which is where we'll be leaving things this episode. Bones is like a less annoying version of Weevil. He has plenty of removal, the trap holes and tributes of a doomed, but he's just nowhere near as bad, nor does he have as many. He also uses Gravity Bind a lot, which bites him too since most of his monsters are also frozen by it. So a lot of the time, it's just both of us with a full front row unable to do anything until I draw Royal Decree, MST off Everduster, and then just run over him. I talk about him as a character, but I don't remember Bones too much from the show itself. I know he was a henchman of Bandit Keith in Duelist Kingdom, and is then possibly murdered by Bakura in Battle City. but his personality or even voice I just don't remember at all. And that's where I'll be leaving this game for this episode. Next episode will cover me getting the remaining 338 cards. I'm starting to sour on the grind here at this point. I should say that it's not the challenge that's doing this. I'd have to get all the cards regardless and the drop rates on them wouldn't change if I saved them for later. But up to 4 hours replaying the same 3 games in a row for one chance at a single card started to get very boring. Yu-Gi-Oh!, at least in the form it was in at this game's release, I don't think was built for this kind of rare drop grinding. But who knows, maybe next episode the RNG will be more merciful towards me.